Alrighty, lads. So, last recording, we ended up witnessing our good friend Constantine dying. Yeah, and now I gotta start the next step of the mission, I guess. So, what even is the next step? We did that. We just go through the tunnels some more then? Yeah.
You hear that? Waves.
Nature takes back what belongs to her. Let's hope the tunnels of this undertrain aren't flooded too.
This video is going to be a shorter video than the previous ones. It's going to be about 30 minutes probably. Just figured I'd state that now.
I know that smell. Stay here. Where did we find Yarrow's wife? Then it really is you. Good question. Best you take a look for yourself. I'll wait here.
Heyo.
So, any explanations?
An illusion.
Yes, of course. Created by this bloody temple. Or maybe even the High Ones.
Yes,
of course. That must be it. They're trying to confuse us. By the wise hermit, they'll do just about anything, won't they? This is just wrong. This is crazy.
Ugh.
Well, working with you is definitely an experience, to say the least. We should push on, find that stupid train. I just want to get out of this place as quickly as possible.
Wait, you don't want to go psychotic? But it worked out so well for Constantine. That has to be the least satisfying and killing blow that I've had all game. Where's the other dude? I just want to see if there's any free loot or anything while we're up here. Nope. Okay.
Bullseye. Seems like the water spared the train. It's beautiful in a way, don't you think? I bet every arcanist would give his left hand just to get a look at it. And we're about to use it. Only thing left to do now is find out how. Seems to me that we first have to open this gate and reactivate the mechanism that powers this place. I'll take a look around. Try and find something that lets us open the gate. This is crazy. Just crazy.
You know, there's probably a lever where I checked and I just didn't see it. There's two levers here. Man. I really can't wait till I get mana restored off that. I got Bastion at the same time, I'm pretty sure. Okay.
Bullseye. Seems like the water spared the train. It's beautiful and... Hey, don't you think? I bet every Arcanist would give his left hand just to get a look at it. And we're about to use it. Only thing left to do now is find out how. Seems to me that we first have to open this gate and reactivate the mechanism that powers this place. I'll take a look around. Try and find something that lets us open the gate. This is crazy. Just...
I really don't like double archers.
Go on inside and take a seat, okay? I'll see if I can get the train running somehow. It can't be too hard.
All right. This is a very interesting location. Right, well then I guess I just sit and then we'll see.
Ta-da! Yes, I'm amazing. I know that. If being a merc doesn't work out in the long run, maybe I'll ask the Order to hire me as an expert on Pyrean railways. But no guarantee this thing won't drive us right into the next abyss. Anyway, I guess even with this thing it should be a while till we arrive. Let's make ourselves comfortable.
As we hear a thud 3 seconds later and then end up in a giant
Sorry
fight.
For the drama back there at the house. I guess I just didn't know what to make of the situation. No idea. And please, save the subtle accusations, okay? If I reacted somewhat inappropriately, I'm sorry. But hey, I'm not the one whose corpse is lying around in some old ruin. Sorry about that. I'm a little on edge right now. No offense intended. If the High Ones were planning to confuse us, they definitely succeeded. We really should tell the Grand Master about this. And about what happened to Constantine. Still, we can't allow this to get inside our heads too much. What matters right now is the mission. And at least it stays exciting. Two daring adventurers who have gotten themselves into something they don't even remotely understand are plundering ancient ruins in search of treasure. Don't laugh, but this reminds me a little of my past. Of my childhood.
What kind of childhood did this man have?
Save for the crazed mages and the mysterious bodies, of course. My sister and I, when we were young, we always used to go exploring the caves near our manor. Father always gave us a good scolding when he got wind of it. But of course, that didn't keep us from doing it again.
Now, this dude had a good childhood. Like, that sounds fun as fuck.
Right. Because I never told you. Adela and I are not exactly close these days anyway. Probably because we lost our bond somehow after our father died. Yes, he did. Together with my siblings. Actually, Adela and I are the only surviving Delverics. All the others were murdered. No need to be. But I appreciate the thought, so thanks. In a sad way, a part of me is actually glad everything happened the way it did back then. It made me into a man, and it showed me what kind of characteristics have a tendency to drastically shorten one's life.
I would argue that some characteristics that would shorten your life are going into a dungeon, fighting gods, fighting the undead, working with magical vehicles, and working with some random dude whose dead body you just saw while still talking to him and telling him your life story.
Stubbornness. My father was a judge in the tribunal, you know. He was a hard man, who at least after our mother died while giving birth to Adela, lived for only one thing. His principles. Justice knows no compromise. That was his great creed. No matter who stood before him in court, my father treated them all the same. Damien Delverick, the epitome of justice. It does to most people. One day, the son of a highly regarded Archer Sublime stood before the 12 judges of the court. Valenzio Duran. He had murdered two whores, made them happy, as he called it, and it was obvious that he didn't feel so much as a hint of remorse. You know those kind of people, the ones who think that money and power entitle them to anything they want. Of course you can. 11 of the 12 judges voted for a verdict of not guilty, because they knew Valenzio's father was influential within the Relata. Only my father, of course, remained unshaken. 1 week later, our manor was robbed by 4 masked men who killed everyone. Servants, guards, my 2 older brothers, all of them. Officially, they were bandits, who just happened to be running around with blades made of shadow steel. My sister and I only survived because we had snuck out for one of our expeditions. Ironic, isn't it?
See, I would stand by the statement of, like, having your beliefs and staying by them. I feel like it's fair, but that's just dumb.
Of course, it was the only logical consequence of my father's actions. And what good did it do in the end? None. As we speak, Valenzio's enjoying himself in some brothel with 2 whores and a bowl of grapes. But you see, there's no point in being angry about this. And do you know why? Because this is just how the world works. There's no divine justice, no system through which it's decided who lives and who dies. There are decisions and there are consequences. That's it. This is also why there's absolutely no point in fighting for ideals, the greater good, or whatever else you want to call it. First of all, because no one will thank you for it, and second, because people are stupid.
That's the one universal rule that there is to this world. No matter how much you try to accomplish something, in the end, stupid people will destroy all you've achieved with no more than a snap of their fingers. Fight for the moment, and the moment only. Because unlike everything else, you can be certain of its truth. No. But if he had wanted Valencio to die so badly, there would have been other ways. Poison, an accident, a hired killer. Just a hint of common sense. That's all he would have needed. But of course, none of that would have conformed to his sacred principles.
Adila and I were still young when all this happened. A friendly family took us in, and my sister joined the Order of the Apothecary in the Frostcliff Mountains. But since then, we haven't been able to speak to one another. She raised a wall of ice around herself, so to speak, and fled into old family books and memories. But, anyway, enough about me. You're an orphan too, aren't you? How come? You never told me about that. You told me that the Creator's Temple in Ostian had something to do with it, but what exactly happened?
Man, I wanted to know what happened. What?
Names. Yeah. I've had my share of nightmares too. There was this one that plagued me for years. I'd be in some kind of hall, almost like a temple. Only that there were benches and aisles, like in a courtroom. My father sat on the judge's dais. But he was a corpse. And all the spectators and the jury were like him. Anyway, there was this grotesque trial scene where he accused me of refusing to do my duty for them. It always ended with his skin melting off like hot wax. Pretty messed up, you know. Eventually, the dream stopped, though. Someone helped me with that. But anyway, enough of this gloomy talk for now. We should get some rest. We've still got a long ride ahead of us. Good night.
Hey, yo, I'm not even in a bed. How am I falling asleep?
Rise and shine, my friend. We have arrived. How'd you sleep? Well, for what it's worth, neither can I. Come on, let's take a look outside.
Alrighty.
Seems someone has prepared a welcome for us.
Alright. So, the moment we're done with this fight, I'm assuming my best course of action will be to, like, save up so I'm not going too far ahead in missions. Oh. Hey. Save real quick. This should hopefully allow me to tank at least one shot. Okay. Okay. So what's the next plan? I kind of want to just cut it here, since... Yeah, I think this is just going to be a good spot to end for now. So I'm going to have a save here, and y'all have a great morning, midday, evening, night, whatever it is. Y'all have a good one. See you guys.